In Iceland, the third volcanic eruption of the Reykjanes volcano this year is almost certain to occur by the end of the week. And when it does occur, there may be as little as 30 minutes of warning beforehand. At the 5-kilometer or 3.1-mile depth magma chamber 1,100 meters south of the Svartsengi geothermal power plant, magma is building in volume at a rate of approximately 4.3 cubic meters per second. Due to the seemingly repetitive nature of Reykjanes' overall volcanic activity since October of 2023, it appears that a new volcanic eruption is most likely to occur between March 1st and March 3rd of 2024. Although we do not know where exactly magma is most likely to erupt from, a number of possibilities have been simulated to determine which areas are most at risk. While a worst-case scenario would involve either an explosive eruption occurring in the ocean or lava erupting in the middle of the town of Grindavik, the most likely outcomes involve lava erupting from a fissure in a similar location to its prior three eruptions since last December. One location which is receiving potential note is the possibility involving an eruption occurring just west rather than east of the feature known as Hagafell. If an eruption did begin there, there are two potential danger zones to keep an eye out for where you do not want lava to flow. The first is a narrow zone towards the east which has the potential to flow around the existing lava barrier to the east and potentially hit structures. The second possibility is more likely and involves lava flowing beyond the reach of the January 2024 eruption lava field, hugging the lava wall until it goes beyond it, potentially striking outlying structures within Grindavik. Although there is no truly safe location for an eruption to begin, the further north you go on the 15-kilometer underlying magma tunnel, generally speaking, the less destructive of an outcome there will be. If lava instead erupted to the north of the white path I have drawn, then it would be quite likely to recover roads overflowed by lava earlier this month and in a worst-case scenario potentially advance onto a section of the Blue Lagoon's parking lot. Due to the increased likelihood of an eruption occurring, the Reykjanes Volcano's hazard map has been updated with a general hazard level increase in most areas. Currently, magma has pooled to a volume of approximately 7.6 million cubic meters in the shallow magma chamber. For reference, all of Reykjanes' recent eruptions have occurred when this very body of magma was filled to a volume of between 8.6 million and 16.8 million cubic meters. However, I have something quite interesting to note. Ever since November 10th, the rate of magma going into the underlying magma chamber has been progressively decreasing, going from 6.94 cubic meters per second leading up to the first eruption to 4.33 cubic meters per second leading up to the last eruption. Additionally, the volume of magma required to trigger a so-called magma run event has also been progressively decreasing, and I believe I know why this is occurring. My interpretation is that magma is increasingly sticking to the edges and especially the bottom of the magma chamber, causing it to grow narrower and narrower as the weeks and months progress. If this pattern continues between 6 and 10 eruptions from now, there will be no magma chamber to fill, potentially causing molten rock to seek a new path to the surface. The simplest path would be a pre-existing one towards the east, causing it to develop in another area. However, it could also travel upwards and erupt directly south of the Svartsengi geothermal power plant. While this is not yet believed to be a hazard, eruptions from this volcano are getting more frequent due to the progressively smaller size of the existing magma chamber, occurring about 2 days earlier each time than the time between the two prior magma run events. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Jeffy Saff for supporting this channel.